Africa, and welcome to another exciting and rich episode of Soul Impressions. To start off with, we have Tumi Makweya, who is a medical practitioner and a passionate gospel singer. Later on in the program, we'll also be featuring another young dynamic man in Africa. His name is David D. He's also with Eid, the music. That one in particular has dedicated his life to serving God through music. But before we go on to Tumi, here are our thoughts for today.
How are you doing?
I'm good. And
yeah.
I must say, quite honored to meet with you because your schedule is quite tight. That is for sure.
Yeah, well, I thank God for being busy.
Mm-hmm. Before we go anyway, tell me more about David D. Who is David D?
Wow, interesting question.
And what, I must say, it's quite rhyming. David D.
David D. David D. David D is a gentleman who was born in KwaZulu-Natal, mm-hmm. Moved to Gauteng. To study, you know, I met God, he changed my life, and I fell in love with music, and music became, you know, a tool for me to win souls, mm-hmm. to influence people. So David is a guy who really, you know, who loves God passionately, mm-hmm. but I show it through music.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You said something quite interesting. You said you met God. Tell me about the meeting of God.
I come from, you know, from the past, you know, where, you know, things were hectic, you know, and God really changed my life. I cannot sit here and say, you know, I was perfect. You know, I did most of, you know, bad things that anyone can think of,
mm-hmm.
you know. When God touched my life, I thought it was impossible for a person like me to be born again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a person was involved in all kinds of evil things. And then when he changed me, He made a different person out of me.
Mm-hmm.
So I can never forget, you know, that time where he changed me. So I met him because before then, you know, if it was not him, I was not going to be here by now.
But you also mentioned earlier, David D, you know, that before you were actually born again, you faced quite a lot of challenges. You've been in the world. You've done, I'm quoting you, you've done all the bad things, you know.
Yeah.
And looking at our society today, we've got a lot of young people also who may be very challenged. You know, we've got HIV and AIDS on the rise. We've got drugs. We've got teenage pregnancies.
Yeah.
Those are things you relate to as a young man. What would you say is significant or is so important for young people, or the journey that the young people should follow in order to reach where you have reached, despite the challenges you faced?
You know, the first thing I think that's most important is love. You know, as a church or as Christians, as believers, we really need to go out there and show love, you know, and love the people. Because when back then, I thought, you know, church folks, you know, were holy people who are ready to go to heaven, you know, ready to go to heaven.
What a misconception!
And then we were, you know, as an unbeliever, you know, then you're a devil's child, mm-hmm. you know, and then already I didn't know that there was something wrong about me. Yes, I knew that I was struggling with weaknesses and this and this and that. But, you know, the life that I had, it was okay. It was the only life that I knew. That by then, you know, most of the Christians that I knew back then, they didn't really show me, you know, the life in Christ. You know, I just saw people who, you know, who always judging, you know, people who are, you know, sort of, you can say, full of themselves.
Hmm.
Until really Christ touched me, you know. Then that's why I realized that it's not necessarily about the building. It's not about the church.
Wow.
Church A, church B, or church Z. It's about Christ. Because when you meet Christ, then that's what you realize about the relationship with him. Hmm. You know, it's a one-on-one thing.
Mm-hmm.
And when I, you know, that's where I realized that my job now as a Christian is to be an example, is to say to a person, yes, I drank a lot. Yes, I smoked all kind of cigarettes. But when Christ came into my life, this is what happened to me. And then by me showing that to you, you know, by me living my life, you know, being this person that I am, who's loving, you know, who's got passion, then people are encouraged. You know, we want to be like this guy.
Mm.
For me to have a project like this, it was not a matter of somebody, you know, I got a lot of money, you know, so okay, go and record. It was a matter of I believe I can do it.
Mm.
And I said, I have no money. I just finished. I've got matric. I don't really have a job. You know, I can't. You know, I can't look. I can't be expecting somebody to, you know, to come up for. So, what can I do? What can I stand up and do? So that's how the project came about. You know, I said, okay, I'll knock at this door. You know, I'll ask this person to help me. I'll sing in a church. I'll make a sing in a concert. I'll, but put one on one until, you know, I have a project. So what can I say? I think the most important thing is to show love.
Mm-hmm.
Most important thing, show people what Christ has done. Mm. You know. It's not enough to talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have to show it. You have to live day by day.
So you're actually saying the love of Christianity as your religion is actually more practical than theory,
but
or
I think,
rather said.
I think, you know, that I believe when they say action speaks louder than words, because you can say a lot of things, you know. But it's very important that our lives, you know, they must reflect Christ.
Mm.
People should see Christ in us. Christ is not around. You're not going to see him in the street. You can only see people. You can only see me and you. So if somebody wants to know who Christ is, a person must see me. Then they must have an idea who Christ is. You know, it's very, very important. And I think we have missed it. Because what happened, there was this in the Bible when the disciple asked Jesus, I mean, who's the neighbor? Who should we be friends with? Who should be our neighbor?
Who should we be friends?
You know, it's not about church folks. It's not about we go to the same church so we speak together. A person that we should be friends with, a person that we should be loving, is a sinner. It's a person who's out there. It's a person who's struggling. It's a person who's failing on certain things. Instead of judging, which Jesus said, I didn't come to judge. I'm not here to judge. You know, the judgment day will come. But for now, I came to, you know, to reconcile you to the Father. That's our job, to love and to show that love.
I'm definitely being preached to here. But you said that actions speak louder than words.
Yeah,
you have spoken, and we're going to continue speaking. I need to get some action. There's a song that I heard a little bit. I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. It's a Zulu song. It says, Bantu Bakete. I just want you to give me just a little bit, just one verse of that song. Please, I'm sure my viewers at home would love to hear this crispy voice.
All right.
Just one line.
Okay. Bantu bakithi ageni bheke isikhathi siyaphela siyaphela uJesu zobuya alilandi banda lakhe ungamehlo azombona.
Wow.
Something like that.
That is beautiful.
Yeah.
Now, tell me, what does that song mean?
Well, when this song came to my spirit, it was, I realized that we have stopped preaching about Christ coming back. Because I remember when I got born again, you know, I just knew that Christ was going to come, you know, that night. And you know, I remember waiting. So 12
to
o'clock.
See him come through.
So you'll come like a thief. I said, okay, 12 o'clock has got to be
I'm
the time.
I'm waiting for him.
And then, you know, we have stopped preaching about that. You know, you don't hear that message anymore. You know, when we are, you go to church, you find we talk about prosperity. You talk about we are staying here, we are living here. You know, let's build your house here. While Jesus said, put your riches in heaven, we say, put your riches here. You know, so this song came to my spirit, you know, remind the people that I'm coming.
Wow.
You know, it says, Jesus obuya, which means Jesus is coming. You know, it might happen to you tomorrow. It might happen to me, you know, today. Mm-hmm. It might happen to you at home, you know, next week. You know, people, a lot of things are happening.
Mm.
You don't know when your life is ending. And when your life ends, that's it. Christ is back to you because you're not going to have another chance. So let's go back to that preaching. Jesus, Christ is coming. What have you done?
Mm-hmm.
As a Christian, what have you done to win a soul? As an unbeliever, what have you done, you know, to fix your life?
This young man is filled with the word of God. That is for sure. Talking of comebacks, I do believe Jesus Christ is coming back.
Yeah.
However, I need you to actually take me to the studio where you can do the actual real thing for me. He talked about Jesus coming back, and we definitely coming back with David D in studio, where we're going to take a snippet of what this man gets to inside closed doors. Don't you go away. So David D.
Yeah.
How do you get this so perfect? Your voice is just so amazing, you know? It gets crispy, it's like it's going, then it comes back.
Wow, I don't know what to say. Well, I just thank God, you know, for the voice that I have. But to tell the truth, when I grew up, I never thought I would sing.
Hmm.
You know, I never thought I was a singer. You know, my mother, you know, teaches music. Well, she used to teach music.
Mm-hmm.
My brothers, they sing, you know. Then I was just one with a funny voice,
mm-hmm.
you know. So I never really thought that I could actually get to sing.
Mm-hmm.
I think what God did, He gave me a message. Then for me, the easy way to pass this message is through a song, because I write a lot of songs.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in this album, I wrote, you know, almost all the songs that are there.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about God, because before I met Him, I was not like this.
Mm.
In fact, people who knew me back then, you know, when they see me now,
they still get a bit surprised.
Yeah, when they see you on TV, it's like, you can sing. I was kicked out in a school choir when I was young.
That's a joke. Tell me you're joking.
It's true. I'll never forget that. In a couple of groups, they kicked me.
Wow.
But you know, then I was still young.
Mm-hmm.
But really, I'm so honored what God has done. Yeah.
You know, that brings a question to my mind about preparation. Do you believe that in your religion, your Christianity, God prepares one for a particular event in their lives?
Oh, definitely. And you know, the funny part. God shows you where you're going,
mm-hmm.
and He doesn't tell you the process.
Oh,
you know, you see your final destination. Mm-hmm. You see what's going to happen.
But you don't know how you're going to get
you
there.
You go with this excitement, but you don't know how you're going to get there.
And there are highs and lows.
There's high and lows.
Mm-hmm.
In the Bible, when you read, there's a guy, Joseph. He had a dream. His brothers were kneeling, you know, in front of him. Guess what? He was in a pit the next day. You know, you show your dream where you're going.
And you wake up, you
find yourself in a pit.
This crazy dream.
After the pit, he was in Potiphar's house,
yeah.
where things were getting together. You know, he was, you know, one of the top guys. Guess what? Back in jail.
Oh.
You know, it's more like when things are getting together, when you think you got your breakthrough.
Then something comes.
Something happened. I mean, same thing with David. He was anointed to be a king.
David
in the Bible.
Okay.
He was anointed, called to be in a palace, you know, serve, you know, Saul. I'm sure he was sitting, he would sit and watch
the
master's chair, and said, this is my chair because I'm anointed to be a king.
Yes.
And guess what? The very same calling, it gets to chase after you.
Oh.
You get to run away. He had to live in a cave, you know, for many years. He even got married while he's staying in the wilderness.
Wow.
You know, it shows that sometimes when God calls you, you go through ups and downs. I'm sure when Samuel was anointing David, you know, David didn't have a clue. That, you know,
what was to come?
This was going to put me in a wilderness.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes when God calls you, we get excited. Of course, it's good. You know, I'm going to move. I'm going to do this. You know, you receive a prophecy. But there is the process.
Hmm.
And that process, you know, you cannot run away from it. You have to go through it.
Hmm.
You know, it will take days.
I thank you very much for having shared
thank you.
The story of your life with us. Hmm. And as I said, I do believe we'll
yes.
go.
I do believe.
Very far.
Thank
and you
very
are busy
much.
With another project.
Yeah.
We wish you all of the best.
Thank you.
Well, viewers at home, you have heard it from David D. As he says that discipline in life and your spirituality, we need to be relevant at all times. And I must definitely say that as Africans, we need to be quite relevant to the times of today. We may have shifted a little bit from our original roots as Africans within the continent, but believe you me, joining hands and keeping on the carriage to make Africa a beautiful continent that we'll all be proud of. Till we meet again next week, right here on Soul Impressions, I'm Moleboheng Matli, signing out from Hilltop Studios in Randburg, South Africa. God bless.
life with no purpose. Where you go every day? Don't even know what you're living for. Beginning, God say, let's make a man in our own image to be a ruler. Everything that is in the season, oh yeah. Every morning you wake up, you sit with your friends the whole day. You talk about the same thing over and over and over. Every morning you wake up, you sit with your friends the whole day. You talk about the same thing over and over and over.
Well, that was really, really beautiful. David D can really sing. And the title of that song is I Do Believe. And right now, I'm sure you believe with me that Africa is going very far. With such talent and the grooming of upcoming talent also, this continent is so rich. But let's continue talking to this young man.
There are a lot of challenges. Most young people can't even study, or others want to pursue the entertainment.
Well, I think the important thing for everybody is find out who you are, because once you know who you are, then you're able to take the right direction. Just have God guide you and know who you are, and that's the only way you're gonna really know yourself. Because if you gotta know the creator, you gotta know a person who's in your eyes. But it's a lot. For me, sometimes if I could trade that time to do other things, I'll do it without thinking twice. But just go at it, and God will probably help you. Well, obviously you. Definitely help you too.
Now, I need us to just do this one more time.
Before
I need you now. I need you now. I need you now.
I need you now.
I need you now.
I need you now.
I definitely can go there. I definitely should come back for some voice training. To one or the other is an inspiration, is a motivation, especially to the young people. You know, it says a lot about our continent and that there are young people out there truly who are striving to make the best out of a life that has been given for God. Thank you so much.
Of turning with thee, thou change will be. Oh, summer and winter, springtime, the causes up above, joins with all nature in thine faithfulness. Great is thine faithfulness, morning by morning, you mercies, mercies I see. All I have needed is faithfulness, yes, yes. Great is thine faithfulness, great is thine faithfulness.
Hello to you beautiful people of the African continent. Welcome to Soul Impressions. I am your host, Moleboheng Matli, better known as Lebo. Today on Soul Impressions, we are featuring a young man who has had a rough time in his life from childhood, but his music has kept him going. We are broadcasting live from Hilltop Studios in Randburg. Let me not give it all to you. Let's go meet the young man himself as he tells us more about his life, his music, and his God. Don't you go away.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, and you?
Hey, good. Good to see you.
It was a journey to get to you. Down the stairs, up the stairs, but yep. Here you are.
Yeah, this is where I'm hiding, this is where I'm working.
This is where you're busy.
Yes.
Welcome to Soul Impressions. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take you away a little from all this busyness so we can talk about your life, your God, and your music.
All right, cool.
Right after the break, we're going to be having a chat with David D about his current album, his relationship with God, and the challenges he's facing as a young man in the industry of music. Don't you go away. Well, I'm sure you're ready to hear what this young man has got to tell us about his life, his God, and his music. David D, welcome to Soul Impressions.
Believe in saying what you don't believe in, because it's the only way that you're going to. And so for me, it was a move that I needed to do to just make sure that no company, no record company. You're the miracle so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You are great. You're the miracle so great. There is no one else.
So much.
And shove Jesus around people's throats, and I'm sure they get tired of it. And
yeah.
You're not able to feed them or clothe them. So yeah. Things like that, you would need to be able to.
My family.
Good news in terms of, I suppose, your heart. Your kindness never ends, just and true. For you exalting your holy name. Is something that will encourage somebody, motivate something. Okay. To me, it is the gospel.
Mm-hmm. And word being used so often.
Yeah.
Can you know?
Just by believing in Him, I can be saved. So.
The sweetest name I know, I know.
Just my right to be daily. And, yeah. So going to hospital, basically between my medicine and my music, and. Though they both start with an
and it's 2 in the morning, 1 cold night. I'm trying so hard.
Need me to.
Oh, I need somebody who knows and understands me day within. Whom can I call? Hold on to His word. He promised to exalt you. Behold His word.
It's more. My own personal type of meditation that I go through, you know what I mean? And it just cleans up and clears up my mind, and suddenly
I need you now. Second, another minute, another day, need you right away.
Welcome, Africa. I'm your host, Lebo. With me right here, I have Tumi, who is a musician, also a medical doctor. For the next coming few minutes, we're going to have lots of fun as we get to know him better. His life, his music, and definitely his career. Tell me more. I'm already excited about this, but let me know Tumi better. Who is Tumi?
But I suppose it principles my parents taught me, and just singing in the Sunday school choir and playing.
Way back with the music.
Way back.
Okay, but then tell me, what is your relationship with God? You say you grew up in church. Does that necessarily mean that you actually do have an existing relationship with God?
Well, so it's not about just church for me. It's about a relationship that I have with God. And based on that, on the relationship I have, I think even my music is just a representation of my...
For us, when you say being born again, what exactly do you mean by being born again?
Okay. Yeah. And being, you know, a musician at your age, quite young, I understand you're also a medical doctor.
Yeah.
Now, music doctor, where do the two combine and how do you actually get it done? Or how do you leave this piano and go to the hospital, or leave the hospital and come to the piano? Yeah. How did Tumi end up being a doctor? Do you specialize? Are you a general practitioner and currently practicing?
I work at a hospital now. I work at a hospital in Tepong. It's called
Joy. It lifts up your spirit. Yeah. And you know, being a general practitioner at a hospital, for that matter, you deal with all sorts of cases. You know, you work basically in the emergency room. As a medical doctor and as a child of God, how do you deal with situations whereby possibly somebody loses their lives in your hands, or far more serious, you know, circumstances, life-threatening emergencies that you have to take care of, and somebody eventually dies and you feel your God is being fake, being unfair? Do you find your religion, one or the other, having influence on the way you should operate as a medical doctor?
But I suppose my one thing that I do is just pray in the morning and I just say, God, help me to do the best I can do. I mean, life is in your hands. You can only do up to a certain point, and on a worst day, I have music to get back to.
So far, you know, in your medical career, what would be mostly challenging in terms of your faith, in terms of your religion?
About Christ, and of course, it's a lot of work. You can imagine it's more stressful in that. At times, I don't have.
So you basically use, you know, the platform you have as a doctor also to minister your faith, to minister
every
the word
opportunity.
Of God.
Every opportunity must just be used. Otherwise, I spend most of my days at the hospital, some nights as well.
I mean, doctor, music label, God, that's a lot of work. Tell me more about your company.
It is about language. It is about the kind of clothing that you wear. We probably have missed it then because we mostly dress out of what our African culture would have us.
Yeah.
And for me, it was not to be limited. I wanted, together with my partners, to start a company that would explore music that will not only be rich and do your traditional stuff that everybody does, but we didn't want to really go out.
On that, does it mean you actually only produce gospel? That's gospel to you.
Gospel to you. You can't take it out. I mean, singing a love song shouldn't be bad.
Yeah.
Singing a dancing song shouldn't be bad either. So it's like
most artists are not so involved, you know, in the in the business side of their music. What motivated you to rather, as a musician, as a performing artist, in actual fact, to also be in the business side of things?
Yourself. I mean, for some people, this is all they have, and singing for them should be part of what brings bread in the house.
Yeah.
Bring out something that's sustainable and income. I mean, we all need money, whichever way, to do whatever you need to do. Mm-hmm. Every daily living needs money too.
Yeah.
Even if you look at it at a point of helping somebody.
Yeah.
We shouted a lot to do that. So we wanted to get into the business side of things as well, just to be in control, because then we can decide whatever we want to decide, do whatever we want to do, whenever we want to. I mean, as God directs us, of course.
We need to discuss. And I'm thinking we definitely must have another time.
Yeah.
You know, we must have a follow-up with you. But one last question, or rather, you know, I wish for you to give our viewers, you know, the young people out there, seeing you, you're a young person, you know, you know, medicine is a long career, 7 years in the university, and here you are, you've got your own business, you're a musician, you're a performer.
Yeah.
There are many people out there, you know, the continent is facing quite industry, but they don't really have anything to fall back on. What word of encouragement would you give to our viewers, you know?
Made you to know who you are, and that's important. And for me, I think everybody needs to go at it.
Yeah.
Whatever it is that you believe that God has called you for, whatever you believe that God has designed you for, find your purpose in life. And that's the most important thing. Because I've learned that there's more fulfillment when I do what I believe I'm called
true.
For mm-hmm. than when I do when other things. Might be helping somebody, it might be good.
I need us to finish what we started with. We leave because I must get my voice in order.
I know.
Lord, I need you now. Get all the things going.
Sure, sure.
But it's been wonderful to me. I've had such a good time and I believe that everything we've discussed, you know.
They fail, Lord, as thou hast meant thou forever. Time and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in the heavens, all witness to thine great faithfulness, yes, mercy. And love greatest than an earth provider. Great is thine. It's just the good news. Anything that's good news is gospel. If it's a love song.
Good
and
news biblically, good news in terms of love.
Like it goes to that. Night, Lord, you are watching me, protecting me from harm. With love and joy, you feel my great and marvelous. Yes, are your doings, Lord? Lord God Almighty, alone our healthy of all honor and praise, all nations bow before your throne, beginning and you're mine. You are my only hope, King of ages. For me, it's rooted in the principles of God, love, whatever, whichever way you look at it. It's the message is
looking at the music.
For me, the reason I wanted to go down that route is because I think that's what actually limits people.
Mm-hmm.
So you end up having to do what you don't. Basically, how I appreciate God and so it's not church.
You know, we often hear this born again. Just break it down.
My sins and that for me is being born again, confessing that Jesus Christ is Lord. And Jesus says, and he's just the same as his holy name. Yes. And to see people who are not feeling good,
mm-hmm.
but for me, I mean, I can't say there's a relationship. But I often have to choose one from the other, and you could imagine what wins at heart.
Of course,
though maybe responsibilities might.
To get back to sleep, so overwhelmed by daily troubles, making matters worse. I'm all alone. Do I stop? Do I lose hope? Somebody please tell me what to do. Call him anytime. Hold on to his promise.
Sometimes when I look at the medical career alone, it's quite demanding. You know, you haven't mentioned that you basically leave your music, which I assume gives you.
And so I had to do something that was stable for everybody and for myself. And for me to end up doing medicine really was something to fall back, reflect on the good things about life. I mean, find reasons why I should be grateful.
Mm.
And you could imagine how what good it does to at least help.
I need you now. Oh, not another. not alone. But Lord, I...
Before we go any further deeper into this, let's have a chat.
Yeah.
To me.
Well, man, it goes a long way. I started music way back in church.
Mm-hmm.
Grew up in church, my father being a pastor, I mean, was raised in church, so you could imagine all those tiring days, tiring Sunday mornings, waking up, going to Sunday school. Didn't really want to go. It worked out for the best because then I was groomed in the house of God and, you know, the principles instilled. And, I mean, music really comes from church, really, I think. So most of the music is really based on my upbringing,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, my beliefs and my belief system, and yeah, how I was raised at home. Then it was kind of nice. It was kind of nice. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you go.
I'm born again. Christ really got a hold of me some few good years back, yeah. And well, people will have different concepts and whatever they wanna. Define it as, but for me, it's really being at a point where I accept that Jesus Christ died for me. It's a bit hard. It's a bit hard leaving the piano and going to.
I can imagine.
Then do other things, but yeah, it's okay. I juggle around and okay. Try and make it work. Temple Hospital is a place in Klerksdorp.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know how I ended there, honestly. It was just one of those things, got good marks, everybody thinks you should be a doctor.
Mm.
And yeah, I found myself there. First few years I thought, what am I doing here?
Am I supposed to be here?
Yeah, and maybe also I had not identified my gifting being music,
yeah.
Per se. On, but
yeah.
Had I had a different choice, I probably would do something different, but no regret. Yeah. Well, for me, it's been a problem, really, trying to separate what I do with how I feel.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, seeing people pass on, it's quite a daunting thing to experience on a daily basis. And yeah, so if you really think you're doing it all, you'll probably crash down.
Yeah.
And you're able to shift your focus from your day and
yeah.
just do something that you can run to if you're not feeling so good. Oh, there's a whole lot of things because I think my challenge basically especially seeing people die. The question I always have is, have they found their savior, or you know, have they found themselves? Do they know where they're going? Do they have their life sorted? And it's a bit of a challenge because you cannot really impress or enforce your beliefs on everybody
mm-hmm.
else. All you could do is maybe suggest or,
mm-hmm.
you know, just let them in on what you believe. But everybody believes in different things. I mean, so it's a bit sad because some people positively
mm-hmm.
or openly rather deny what you're saying. They don't want to hear
mm-hmm.
a bit of it. But yeah, you take every chance you have to justify. I have time to get to my music, and I wish I had more time to do
mm-hmm.
that. But I'm glad I'm helping in a way that I could.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
So if I don't use that, I'd probably see nobody
yeah.
in between. So I'll probably be doing no.
Mm.
Well, we've got a company with two other friends. It's called MKT, which stands for Mekonko Entertainment.
Mekonko.
Yeah, Mekonko, which really speaks about the beat.
Cool.
Yeah. So. The idea of the label was actually to come up with something that is different. I think personally, I don't believe being African is really should be limited to language.
Of course, yeah.
And anybody who believes that, you know,
mm-hmm.
but that will extend to the rest of the world because, I mean, we felt we had a message that
yeah.
needs to be held by everybody
yeah.
out there. So basically, that's what MK2 is about. It's about a youth
mm-hmm.
group that is comprised of two ladies
mm-hmm.
and a guy. And yeah, I mean, it's youthful people, very talented,
yeah.
and we just wanted to do something different and break all the rules and just
yeah,
go
yeah.
all out at it. And our aim was not really saying, let's do something that would make money.
Yeah.
Because if it was, we would have went the popular route of who
mm-hmm.
we are. We wanted to express ourselves in the
mm-hmm.
way that God has gifted us.
Yeah.
So that you don't have a lot of Rebeccas and a lot of Lundis and a lot
yeah.
of everybody else.
There's variety.
You know, yeah, give young people something else to listen
something
to.
Something they can relate to. Okay.
Exactly.
So, are you open to all genres of music?
Well, currently, yeah. I mean, I've done something that is outside. Well, it depends what gospel to you is.
What's
the principle of God? Yeah. God is love. So you can't take it.
Industry generally
make money or stay limits me and say you gotta do this if you wanna get paid. But at the same time, I mean, you just need to be wise and make sure that you're able to. But yeah, it just allows us to expand and to do everything the way we want it to happen. Fresh thing, fresh sound, and yeah, we just started. It's not a huge label yet. Give it some time, give it a few weeks or months or whatever. But yeah, we're taking it one step at a time, and God has been good. There have been some doors which have been opened, and we've been able to do certain things. Yeah, you could imagine.
And in this baby, MK2 baby, are there any artists yet within the stable?
Are you working on that? The first group that we got, we started a group called Intense.
You know, Tumi, also, you know, juggled with that. I understand you just launched actually your own music label.